think every actress read very several parts. I think Mahandra Delfino read for Isabel and her character as well as Liz. I know that Sherry read for all three parts, and maybe even Katie Heigl could have read for a couple of the parts, I know.
Yeah.
But it got to the point with Sherry, an interesting story was the fact that A.J. Buckley, who's an actor that I've worked with before, was a friend of mine. He showed me a picture of Sherry mm-hmm. and said, you should at least read this girl. And I said, well, okay, I'll read it. We'll read her. I did it as a friend. And
she's been trying to get in to read for this role.
Exactly.
And, you know, it's very hard when you want to, you know, a lot of people are trying to get in to read for the role. And she couldn't get in, and it's just through this fluke.
Through a true fluke. And when she walked in the door, Jason and I just went, wow. I mean, it's great when you look in someone else's eyes and you're both thinking the same thing and having the same thoughts. And this was one of those moments that just happened.
And also on the other side of the coin here in terms of casting is Jason Baer. And, you know, this particular scene actually is the moment for me that, when I was on set watching this scene being done, is when I thought, wow, we have a show here. And it goes back to what David has said from the beginning, which is, we can't play this thing like a joke. The premise is too sort of crazy to play it as a joke. We gotta play it serious. He's gonna believe it. And when I saw Jason Baer do this scene and the intensity of it, and Sherry as well, how they just sort of, you know, they believed it, they were living it. I thought this was the moment I thought this is going to work. It was really kind of great.
If you watch this moment he does with the finger, I actually I did an X-Files episode, and Mike Gomez and David Duchovny in the Arecibo Labs does something about seeing people from outer space, and he does something very similar, and I said, wow, what a great moment that can be, and it just fit right into this for us, and it played out perfect.
The cells weren't normal. So, Max, what I'm going to suggest to you is that we just go back into the bio lab now so that I can take a sample so that I can see what I'm thinking is wrong, you know? That I got the wrong cells.
You didn't.
Okay, so help me out here, Max. I mean, what are you?
Well, I'm not from around here.
Where are you from? Up north. You're not an alien. I mean, are you?
Well, I prefer the term "not of this earth." Sorry, it's not a good time to joke. Yeah, I am.
Which is when I wrote the original script. This idea of him pointing was not in it. I think he just said it. And David, and I had no experience in the genre of science fiction. And David, of course, had come from, you know, X-Files and any number of things. And so he sort of knew how to do this stuff. And so when we were talking about the scene and he came up with that idea of pointing to the air, I got so excited because I thought, you know, it's just so great because sometimes it's what you don't say and what you can't say. And I just thought, oh my God, that's going to be right there. That's the promo right there. That moment was perfect.
And I myself, it was the same thing. I remember shooting that day and I remember the producer coming over to me and saying, we got to shut down. I'm going like, No, we got to get this scene. This is the most important scene in the show, and if we don't get this scene, this is what sells the show, I think. And it was quite something. It worked out great. Well, Colin Hanks, let me just say, he walked in the door to casting, and Jason and I This is a guy that it's so natural for him, and it worked so well for him, and he was just fantastic. We'll talk more about him, but with respect to this is actually a pilot for 20th Century Fox, the Fox Network originally. Then once the pilot was finished, the WB saw the pilot, and then they picked it up for an entire season. And basically, Fox, what they were looking for is they were trying to find a young Calista Flockhart, because this is the time Ally McBeal was so popular. So we basically read every young actress in town to try to find a character with his qualities. Someone that, of course, is television attractive, but also who has humor and has depth and has drama and has all the things that you're gonna hopefully dream for in a lead for a show such as this.